Since the COVID-19 pandemic began, the things we spend time thinking about have changed. And social distancing has definitely been front of mind. Yet in practice, we're not always that good at it. So maybe we could learn something from the animal world.
We are not the only ones that are constantly facing infectious diseases. And so animals have evolved these strategies to cope with these diseases as well.
Scientists have found that many species in the animal kingdom practice social distancing. Insects, monkeys, fish, rodents, birds, and bats. But not all animals do it the same.
There's plenty of different mechanisms by which animals socially distance. But I think one of the most common mechanisms is just avoidance, which has been studied quite a bit. And that is just a healthy animal avoiding a sick animal.
Spiny lobsters avoid other sick lobsters. They can detect illness in urine and will abandon the safety of a nice crevice if they pick up the scent. Honeybees are a little less forgiving. They've been observed forcibly kicking sick bees out of the hive. Vampire bats, when sick, become lethargic and don't interact with other bats as much. Whether intentional or not, this lessens the likelihood of passing on the illness. But of all the animals that socially distance, ants could be considered the champions.
If one individual brings in an infectious disease, that would spread like wildfire. And so in response to that, they have evolved these very elaborate measures to prevent that from happening.
Ants have been observed giving each other more space than normal when sick ants are around. And in the most selfless act, sick ants will actively stay away from their nest. They'll self-isolate to keep their colony safe.
In these ants, everybody pulls on the same string, and it's like this coordinated response that prevents that pathogen from spreading.
It's this all-in devotion to social distancing that humans could learn from. Of course, our motivations are quite a bit more complex.
We sometimes have like selfish motivation. We can see right now that we're doing things that are not benefiting everyone. We're doing quite the opposite. So sometimes we're not all pulling on the same string.
But if humans took social distancing as seriously as ants do, we might have stopped the pandemic before it even really started.